सो गुड इवनिंग इंडिया, दिस इज अमृतांशु वाजपेयी, योर रेगुलर होस्ट, वेलकमिंग यू टुडे ऑन टुडेज ऑल इम्पोर्टेंट डे व्हेन वी आर हैविंग ए टॉक ऑन वन ऑफ द मोस्ट फेवरेबल हॉट स्पॉट्स और यू कैन से हॉट टॉपिक ऑफ द मंथ, द सोलर इक्लिप्सेस. एंड सो आई फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एक्सटेंड ए वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू द गेस्ट ऑफ ऑनर ऑफ द डे, डॉक्टर भरत अडूर, डायरेक्टर आकाश गंगा सेंटर फॉर एस्ट्रोनॉमी. एंड And a hearty welcome to all the audience and special guests amongst us. And when I am having a glance over the audience list, I am seeing Dr. Y. Ravi Kiran, the director, Nehru Planetarium, Prayagraj. And I can also see Vijay Raghavan sir, Sugumar sir, Chogule sir, and also I am getting a feel of TMW part one. So welcome all the special guests amongst us. And I welcome you all on behalf of Sky Foundation, the platform which is allowing us for the meet of the evening, scientific knowledge for youth. I extend a warm welcome to you all on behalf of all the coordinating agencies, Ignited Minds DeepNet Club, Sky Amateur Astronomers Club, Women-led Science Club, and also not to forget our international collaborating partner, EduSTEM Initiative Global from Seattle. और आज की संख्या विशिष्ट संख्या होने जा रही है. आज हम लोगों को ज्वाइन किया है आकाश गंगा सेंटर फॉर एस्ट्रोनॉमी के डायरेक्टर डॉक्टर भरत अडूर ने, और मैं सभी कोलैबोरेटिंग संस्थाओं की तरफ से यहां के सभी दर्शकों का और अपने मुख्य वक्ता, सायंकाल की इस सभा के मुख्य वक्ता डॉक्टर भरत अडूर का स्वागत करता हूँ. स्वागत है सर आपका. और सोलर एक्लिप्स, जैसे कि हम जानते हैं, अक्सर हम लोग कहा करते हैं कि ये ग्रह चालों और छायाओं का खेल है. इट इज ए गेम ऑफ शैडोज, मोशन एंड द मूवमेंट ऑफ द डिफरेंट सेलेस्टियल बॉडीज विच आर प्रेजेंट इन द यूनिवर्स, इन आर कॉस्मोस. सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी टाइम, बिकॉज आई नो यू पीपल आर हियर टू हियर द एड्रेस ऑफ द चीफ गेस्ट ऑफ द डे, सो लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस गिव यू ए ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट द गेस्ट ऑफ द डे, डॉक्टर भरत अडूर. डॉक्टर भरत नागेश अडूर is right now serving as the director of Akash Ganga Center for Astronomy, an institution established by him after serving the nation. He has had a long legacy of chasing the solar eclipses for past 40 years since 1980, a PhD from Lyon Observatory, France, in his theory and study of the globular clusters and the galaxy, beginning his professional careers from the Tata Institute of Fundamental Research and gaining heights at the Indian Institute of Astrophysics, Bangalore, subsequently, and also not to forget the Nehru Planetarium, and right now, Mumbai, and Raman Research Institute, Bangalore, with number of prestigious honors under his name and uncountable number of publications of national and international fame. Dr. Bharat Adur is an institution in himself, and we are very grateful that we are having such a man of repute today on our platform of scientific knowledge for youth. So without wasting any time, I would straightforward invite the speaker for the day, Dr. Bharat Adur, to kindly grace the occasion with a digital round of applause on this digital platform. And before Dr. Sir begins his speech, I would just roll out a couple of instructions for all the esteemed audience who are here. Number one, kindly mute yourself when you are joining. मेरा सभी से करबद्ध निवेदन है, हाथ जोड़कर मैं आप सभी से निवेदन करता हूं कि कृपया अपने आप को म्यूट कर लें जब आप हमारी मीटिंग को ज्वाइन करें, क्योंकि इससे जो है, जब आपकी आवाज जो है हमारे वक्ता के साथ में मिक्स होती है, मिंगल होती है, तो एक अच्छी छवि जो है हमारे प्लेटफॉर्म की नहीं, वक्ता तक नहीं जाती है, और आप भी जो है हमारे वक्ता की स्पीच को अच्छे से एंजॉय नहीं कर पाते हैं. और दूसरी और बहुत महत्वपूर्ण बात, अक्सर ये लोगों को समस्या आती है कि उनको स्क्रीन पिन होते हुए नहीं, उनको स्क्रीन, हमारी प्रेजेंटिंग स्क्रीन नहीं दिख रही है. तो मैं उन सभी लोगों को, आप सभी लोगों के सामने एक बात बताना चाहूँगा कि हमारे वक्ता डॉक्टर भरत अडूर के नाम से दो आइकन हैं. देयर विल बी टू आइकॉन्स ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ डॉक्टर भरत अडूर. फ्रॉम वन ही विल बी स्पीकिंग वेयर यू कैन सी हिम और आइदर इज आइकॉन, एंड फ्रॉम द सेकेंड इट विल बी द प्रेजेंटिंग स्क्रीन दैट विल बी एन एरो पॉइंटिंग अपवर्ड. सो यू कैन पिन ओवर योर ऑल दैट, देयर विल बी थ्री बटन्स फॉर यू, द लेफ्ट विल बी द म्यूट एंड देन द पिन एंड देन लीव द मीटिंग. सो यू कैन पिन दैट स्क्रीन ऑफ डॉक्टर भरत अडूर सो दैट यू कैन एंजॉय द प्रेजेंटेशन. सो आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट फाइनली to all the participants and audience to kindly mute themselves, and I would hand over the baton to Dr. Bharat Adur. Over to you, sir. Welcome to the Sky Foundation platform.
Namaskar. I'm speaking. My name is Bharat Adur, and I'm very happy to have all my friends listening to me. The first most important I have to share with you that even today when I am talking to you, I have to remember one thing, that all these eclipses or otherwise, my interaction with corona began in 1980. So the best part of the corona, I never realized now that we are in a corona. So with your kind words, Amritanshu, thank you once again. And I will like to share my thoughts about all the eclipses that I have been able to see, and why I am chasing, I really don't know. At the end of the talk, I have my own opinions about this eclipse and other eclipses also. And I'm looking forward for young people to take this mission to go for solar eclipses. Generally in India, now the trend is far better than what it used to be in 1980. Then it used to be only groups which could go. Now any individual can also plan and go and see an eclipse. But first and foremost, I want to share with you is what is time light of eclipses. And you will just wonder how this kind of an image can come. First and foremost, when in 1980 I saw the eclipse, I could not imagine what I was looking at. There were goosebumps on my whole body when I saw the eclipse. But prior to the eclipse, there was something which was coming, the shadow was approaching us, and people were seeing that shadow on the ground, and everybody was saying, oh, something is coming, vibrating and coming towards us. Later on, we were able to record it as a shadow bands. So this was our first instance with a solar eclipse. So here I am going to share with you some of the thoughts about what are eclipses and what eclipses are supposed to be. I know all of you are interested today in this solar eclipses, because there is one which is going to happen on June 21st, and we had already planned for going for the eclipse, but unfortunately there will be no trains operating from Mumbai. But I hope the other people who are there in other parts of the country should make it a gesture to go and see the eclipse. And the first, there are four types of eclipses which I'm going to suggest you, because you are seeing it on the screen. I'll just highlight a total eclipse or a total solar eclipse, where the sun is completely covered by the moon and you are able to see the corona. Now here comes the word corona. So the first word of corona, I heard it in 1980. I had read about it, but my first interaction with corona began in 1980. After that, there were annular eclipses also, and I had an opportunity of seeing at least 3 to 4 annular eclipses. But here, only one sad part is that we were not seeing much of the corona, but we were looking at the sun as if it was a ring. Then comes hybrid eclipses. In fact, I hope I can be able to see what is an hybrid eclipse, and definitely I would love to see it along with all of you. And a partial eclipse is already seen by many. When you are not in the path of the eclipse, you tend to see a partial eclipse. And in the partial eclipses also, one thing in all these eclipses one should remember that you can't see an eclipse with naked eye. Please remember this, that you should not look at an eclipse without a mylar glass, mylar filter or ND5 or maybe even a welding glass. But normally we would suggest you to go for an ND5 filter, or better is now available mylar filters. So in all these eclipses, one thing you should remember is your eyes have to be protected. Why your eyes are important? Because your eyes do not have pain cells. Remember, your eyes do not have pain cells to tell you if there is a damage to your retina. So please be careful while looking at an eclipse. Try to see through a filter, mylar filter or an ND5 filter, and that will be safest for you to see an eclipse for as long as you want. But again, there is a word of caution which I normally want to tell you. Always don't try to look at any eclipses for more than 3 to 4 minutes. After that, you let your eye get back to its normal process, and then you try to see again if you want to see the eclipse. This is my small suggestion to all my friends who are going to see the eclipse. Now we will move further, and I have already mentioned here that the eclipse, the sun distance from Earth is about 400 times the moon distance, and the sun's diameter is about 400 times the moon's diameter. This ratio is normally half a degree. In normal terms, if you extend your right hand and lift your right finger up, you can actually cover either the sun or the moon, but don't try to do it and look at it for a very long time. Please remember this. And then another important thing that I have to share with you is the moon's orbit around the Earth is not circular. It is slightly elliptical, and hence we do see either a total solar eclipse or an annular solar eclipse or even an hybrid. Again, I am making myself clear, I have not seen any hybrid eclipse so far. However, partial eclipses, I have seen it right from my childhood. But in those days, we were compelled to look at the eclipse through the water. But that water had to be darkened so that our eyes are not damaged. But this is what it was there in our childhood days. But definitely, I would strongly suggest this eclipse, which is going to happen on June 21st, is going to be also a very interesting event. And I'm not going to say that how you are going to observe it, what type of experiments you have planned. As we proceed, I'm going to tell you many, many things. Now, this was the eclipse that we saw on February 16, 1980, Belambar in Angola. All the key important information, what type of magnitude, what was the maximum eclipse. It was a long eclipse. Please remember. And let me share with you, for this solar eclipse, we had already had an association in Bombay, which was called as Amateur Astronomers Association. And this was at St. Xavier's College. And this team was led by late Professor R.V. Kamath, who was the president of Amateur Astronomers Association. And let me tell you, I'm very happy to tell you this, at this eclipse, we did have people from TIFR, ERL, and also from many other institutions. And we were a group of over 80 people. there were two buses we had hired from Mumbai to go to Ankola, and then from Ankola we went to Berambar, and Berambar there was a small hillock called as Harkin Gudda. Now at Harkin Gudda, our camp was at Harkin Gudda, which was at a height of roughly 200 feet, which means we were fairly close to the sea and we could see the shadow coming from the sea towards us. And that was one, and I'm very happy to share with you, a lot of students had planned different experiments for this eclipse. There was photography group, there was spectroscopy group, then there was shadow band group, and then we had one doctor's group which was actually going around the camp and checking all the 80 people's blood pressure and then heartbeat and all that. And finally, at the end of the whole program, they had nothing to give very concrete. Yes, I have to also mention here, Xavier's College had a zoology department. They had conducted some very interesting experiments. They had carried pregnant mice for this event. There were standard, they had kept some of them in their labs here in Bombay, and the other they were carrying it to Berambar, Ankola. And after they were exposed to the eclipse, they were brought back, and then they had done the test on that, and there was nothing that they could report about. There was a report which was made then by Amateur Astronomers Association, and it is still available as a book, is in a book form, where all these informations is recorded. So this was one eclipse wherein the only medium of photographing was films. And getting films in Mumbai was also very difficult. So we had to get films much, much in advance, and they were all Kodachrome or Ektachrome films. And Kodachrome films had to be developed by only, because at that point of time, most photographic labs would not process Kodachrome films. They used to process only Ektachrome, including places like Central Camera and places around Bombay VT, or rather CST. They used to process the films also. And fortunately, many of these films we were able to get from Kodak directly, because their office was also fairly close to CST, and then we had to request them to save some Kodachrome films for us. So that was, Kodachrome was primarily used as a slide film, and processing that, one had to go to a lab to process this film. The Ektachrome and then other cameras people were able to do. Fortunately, the cameras in those days did not have the DSLR facilities. So we had to do a lot of trials prior to the February 16th. Yet, I will tell you, there were mishaps. Please remember this. There were mishaps. There was a huge burst of wind which toppled our spectrograph. So there was no possibility of picking up any flash spectrum. So that part of the experiment was lost. Some part, people who were trying to observe shadow bands, they did have problems because their cameras, they could not... There were movie cameras, but then these movie cameras got lashed, or rather hanged, and they could not take pictures. This was also true for cameras also. Many people, when they saw the event, they forgot that they have to photograph the event. So this was also there. So don't be under this impression, okay, that the eclipse at the first go, you will get the images. Today we are in a far, far superior position. We have DSLRs and we can go to the sites wherever they are total eclipses and then photograph. Only one thing I must share with you. Weather is something which one needs to look for at least 50 years. The weather pattern in those regions. This 1980 eclipse, we had to study what was the eclipse 80 years back, what was the weather pattern then and thereafter. So this was the few hints that I thought I will share with you for the first solar eclipse that we were able to see. Now here, you will also see in the images, there were few important things which people found was fascinating. One was the diamond ring over here. There are two diamond rings that you normally see for any total solar eclipse. And the best part is, many people are fascinated by a diamond ring, and then when the eclipse takes place, they are shut, or rather they are freezed, and again when the second diamond ring appears, suddenly they want to shoot it, but the cameras, the films are not advanced. Now this was the next eclipse. So this eclipse, we saw it from Novosibirsk in Russia. So the bug had already caught up with me that to chase for the eclipses. So the second eclipse that I had to see was in Novosibirsk. Now let me share some more interesting feature about this eclipse. As you will see, that corona is not just, actually corona means what? Corona is the atmosphere of the sun which you are not able to see it along with the sun. It's so strong, the sun's light is so strong that you are not able to see the atmosphere. But remember one thing, the solar photosphere is at a temperature of about 6000 degrees, whereas the temperature of a corona is 1,000,000 degrees. Please remember this. So you're looking at 1,000,000 degree temperature after the sun is completely covered by the moon. So these are the features which normally one is not able to see during a total eclipse. So what we had to do is, we used to make, in the photographic studios, we used to make masks. You understand what are masks? We used to cut, we used to make the moon completely dark, keep it on the eclipse itself, and try to pull out the features like these, which are called as plumes. And sometimes we used to find, not only plumes, we used to find such coronal helmets. Now these coronal helmets were also very important for finding out what kind of temperatures, how does the temperature from 6000 degrees goes across forming these plumes like petals. They are like rose petals coming out of the sun, and that you are able to see it during the eclipse. Now with your naked eye, the question is, can we really see these things? My answer to this is, during the totality, you can completely remove your filter and see the corona. And that is a beautiful event, a magnificent event, and you cannot miss these plumes, these streamers. I think many of you must have seen the 95 eclipse. I don't know how many of you have seen, but 95 eclipse also did show a huge coronal streamer on two sides like this. over here and here, they were able to see. And on my left-hand side, you will see all the specifications where we had been able to do. But remember, again, these exposures were done only with films. And as I say, Ektachrome 400 was the ISO or the ASA of these films, which we used to use. And the mechanism or instruments were very simple. Simple telescopes. And in those days, Mylar filters were not so widely available. So we had to use ND filters or maybe darkened film, which was called as a contrast films. Now we had to already make contrast films to see a totality. I mean, the partial part. But when the totality used to happen, we had to remove the filter and see the eclipse. And let me tell you, at least so far for me, I was able to see 18 solar eclipses. So, and then how do we do all this work? We have to have fairly large number of images. And mind you, if you have these images, on your printer, you have a scanner. Isn't it? On your printer, you have a scanner. We used to keep the film on the scanner and scan the film. And that's how we could digitize our images. So this was a process. They have given the exposure times from 1 by 500 to about 1 second. But while developing it, also we had to take all the possible precautions. This eclipse lasted for about 1 minute and 32 seconds. And how I was able to see this, I was in Lyon at that point of time, and the Lyon Observatory had planned a mission to Novosibirsk and then to Belova, where we were able to see this event. So, and we were then hardly 25 to 30 people, so we were able to see this eclipse. So we move further, and then we move to 1983. You will wonder, this eclipse happened in Java, Indonesia. I was not very sure I would be able to go for that eclipse. I'll tell you very simple, because Tanjung Kodok and Indonesia are islands. Please remember this. There are more than 1,300 islands. And the largest island is Sumatra, but Sumatra is an island in Indian Ocean towards the Bay of Bengal. And Java is towards the lower, which are called as Timor Seas. Over there, this place is there called Java. We were in a place called as Tanjung Kodok. Very interesting event this was. Completely forest, rainforest, and constant rains. And at this eclipse, we had set up, again, we were three people who were sponsored by Amateur Astronomers Association, Mumbai, to go for this eclipse. Now, here I want to share some interesting information with you. Our trip to this eclipse was partially sponsored by Shipping Corporation of India. There was their ship which was going from Madras to Singapore. And from Singapore, we had to fly to Jakarta, and from Jakarta we had to go to Tanjung Kodok. So our journey was divided by Shipping Corporation, and thanks to Shipping Corporation people who gave us a free ride from Madras to Singapore and back, because we went by the first ship and came back by the second ship. So that freedom they gave us, and we were allowed to go for this eclipse. And then even the airlines, Singapore Airlines, gave us a lot of concession to move from Singapore to Jakarta. And mind you, when there are eclipse chasers, there are many, many helping hands. Please remember this. Eclipse cannot be achieved by only by single people and big money. You get a lot of helping hands to help you through all your missions. And this mission, we were able to do it from Tanjung Kodam. On my left, you will see the screen. On the screen, you will find the details, which I know it's very difficult, but you are able to see many of this. And what I want to tell you here about this eclipse is, the day prior to the eclipse, we had a large storm, very large storm on that island. And along with us, there was a team from Indian Institute of Astrophysics, Physical Research Laboratory. We were from Bombay, that is Amateur Astronomers Association, and Nehru Planetarium, Mumbai. And I think we were three or four organizations from India which we were able to make it to Tanjung Kodam. And during that storm, all our setups were disturbed. All our setups. Our camera mountings were completely brought down. Even, unfortunately, PRL's spectroscope also had toppled. IAA's instrumentation had also toppled. So for us, after the event, after the severe storm, we had to again set it up. Here I will tell you that again you had to set it up, and that took us the whole evening and the night, and again in the morning we were ready. Now you may be wondering, in all these eclipses, whether it is in Russia or India, how are the people reacting to this? People, I am talking of general people. Even in Tanjung Kodam, the locals over there refuse to look at the eclipse on religious grounds. We had one guard to guard our camp, and he told us very categorically that he will not look at the eclipse. And that time we had to manage ourselves. So that is how the eclipse is. It's not necessarily only we say, oh, India is a religious country, people flock to go to the rivers and take a bath and all that, but it is there all along. Even in Indonesia, we did see people not going at the riverside, but they were going towards the seaside. They were also taking a bath. So these events, I was really shocked. I was under this impression that this is only in India. Even in Russia, I found many people, the local people, refused to look at the sun, the eclipse sun, and they went inside the house. Now, such events also do happen even in places which we have visited. Whether it is this place or that place, it is immaterial, but it happens. People all over the globe, as I see it, have their beliefs and they follow those beliefs. So I have nothing against those beliefs, but the fact which I wanted to share with you is that the eclipse is not just looking at the corona. There are many, many events happening at the corona. And I will tell you, at this eclipse, we were near the seaside, and this Tanjung Kodam is essentially, Kodam over there is a frog. The shape of the hillock over there was the shape of a frog, which is not very far from Surabaya. And Yes, we did meet a lot of our own Indian communities who came with lunch packs for us. Whether we are going to eat, not during the eclipse, after the eclipse. And we did share their food. So don't worry, the food was also, the Indian style of food was also available at Tanjungpura. So then the question arises, how did we all look at the solar corona? Corona has not been only after 932 BC or so on. Please remember this. We had in our Vedic astronomy also people like Gargi who were observers of eclipses. And in Gargi Samhita, he gives an account of solar eclipses seen during that period. I will tell you when I come to another issue, I will tell you a story which happened in India itself, but in Rajasthan, Bharatpur. But I will not say anything much about it. But the eclipses as mentioned here was from 1751 is not completely true. There were eclipses which were observed in, not only in India, in China also. In South America also, people were looking at these events. It's not that the event happened only sometime when we understood Macmillan science. No. We knew that there are eclipses and we should not look at eclipses. And we were also given to understand that eclipses are also to be measured. When they will happen, when was the Saros cycle. All this information you do get even in Indian literature. Now, so where I was trying to tell you that the eclipses were also done by later people also. But what normally we tend to understand is, pardon? We tend to understand that the only after 1800 people started knowing more and more. Yes, people started knowing more. I am not denying that fact. But the fact is that this eclipses was studied all over the world. And for your information, I want to share you some more information about how the eclipses were studied in India. Do you know that the discovery of helium was done in India by a French astronomer called Jules Jennison? Along with him, there was a team of Indian astronomers called as Nigamwale and his team. They were from Pune. They went all the way to Guntur, and at Guntur, they were able to look at the eclipse, and there they were able to find helium lines spectroscopically, of course, and they were able to find helium lines. So this happening is also in India, and eclipses in India were also being observed later in the 17th and the 18th century by Kodaikanal Observatory. So it is not that the observations were not there in India. So as I tell you all this, we rarely know that how is the corona made up of? Are there coronas also on the surface of sun? And the answer is yes. Now the coronas which are on the sun, they look at dark patches. And these are called as coronal holes. They are seen in the polar regions of the sun, equatorial regions of the sun, and that probably you can see it in NASA and Solar Dynamics Observatory. But besides that, I want to tell you one very interesting thing, that these maps and their resolutions has considerably improved in the present times. Considerably. You have Photoshop, you have Photoshop now, you have advanced Photoshop in which you can actually analyze your images. It's not anymore a realm of any peer institutes or solar observatories only. Now it has come on your laptops and on your computers. All that one needs to do is to know the basics, what are there on the sun and the corona. You can even measure. I will, at the end of my talk, I will show you the most resolved image of 2017 eclipse. And then you will wonder whether this corona has tendrils, it has coronal streamers, you have a host of animals coming out of the sun. Yeah, so here I have given a recent paper of 2020 made by Benjamin Boye, Shadi Habil and Druk Mule. And this paper actually talks about magnetic field topology. Topology is a word from geometry, which tells you why these tendrils are coming out of the sun. And these tendrils which are coming out are fully magnetic in origin, are completely magnetic in origin. And this field topology for coronal magnetics is now becoming a big subject for young astronomers. And I'm requesting my young friends here that you're not just going for an eclipse. This is what will come into you, that what is happening, what is happening. And this is sun being the nearest star, it is giving you all the features that are there on its surface and beyond its surface. And for your information, these coronals which are coming out of the sun are coming all the way to the earth also. Sometime back, you must have read on your radio channels that many of your internets or maybe your mobiles were not able to operate. There was a shift of magnetic field at the sun itself, and this was causing this kind of a hampering. And here again, I would like to share with you one very important issue. Sun is also a radio emitter. Even if you have a small camera or radio telescope or a Yagi antenna, you can hear the sun at 14 megahertz, 21 megahertz. I think there is a whole range where the sun is trying to talk to us through radio also. I'm not talking about large telescopes. I'm just talking about simple Yagi antennas. Only that you have to have a good receiver. And remember this, that as I told you on this paper is very interesting. You must see this paper, which will tell you that corona by itself has so many components built into it. And for me, for going for any eclipses, for every eclipses, that is there in my mind. Whether I am going to see something new, whether we are going to find, there's one thing which I want to, should I share with you? I want to share this with you. You should look for if there are any coronal mass condensates, which means within the wires, within the magnetic field lines, there are cooler regions of corona, which are encapped between the two coronal streamers. Now that we are trying to look for. They are not being successful so far, so good. So we'll be chasing more eclipses. Can we have the next slide? Now this eclipse is a very unique eclipse. For me, I was looking at this eclipse for pure 6 minutes and 30 seconds. The longest solar eclipse, and that we were observing from La Paz, California, New California, Baja California, Mexico. And you will see that the sun was there, completely there, for full 6 minutes and 30 seconds. So why? Again, we had only films. But what we were able to see, this was happening in a desert. This was happening in Baja Desert in Mexico. And just before the eclipses, we were seeing owls coming back into the roost. Rattlesnakes making noise and going into the pits. And then further, most interesting, smaller animals were trying to hide. And we were put up in a very large camp at La Paz, for there were people from all over the world looking at this eclipse. And let me share this information with you. Longest eclipse, theoretical, is 7 minutes and 12 seconds. And we were looking for this eclipse for 6 minutes and 30 seconds. By the time, I will tell you, no eclipses are alike. No eclipses. Whether be a shorter eclipse or a longer eclipse, but the way the eclipse and the corona reveals is fabulous, is truly fabulous. People were dancing after seeing this eclipse, and it was more of a, not a beer dance, it was an eclipse dance. They were so happy, so happy. And after seeing a corona and then to dance, here we were able to see it. So this is also what I want to share with you. In spite of the corona, which we are all locked down to, there is a corona which is going to bring you out and make you good nature observers. Can we move to the next slide? Again, this is the same eclipse, except that you will see the streamers are streaming out. How far? If you take the sun's diameter and make 20 times the sun's radius, you will find the streamers going that far. So you can well imagine what would be happening every day when the sun is giving out so many coronal streamers. And again, all these images were taken on Kodachrome and later digitized. So there is nothing that these images were only possible for great setups. No, you can also do this. It is not that we were able to do it or somebody. Yes, when you are going to observe it, there are helping hands to tell you what you should be doing, how much should be your exposure. This kind of learning is a process which you learn during a solar eclipse. Can we move next? Now you see the same eclipse. I have given you the same coordinates, and the number of people over there was to more than 4,000 to see this event at La Paz. So you can well imagine what each camera was able to get. So don't be under this fear that sun will be definitely showing its different faces to all its observers. Remember this. We were able to see the faintest star was 6.2 magnitude. We had telescopes, we had cameras, we had good people to help us, and all this was possible. So a solar corona, the longest eclipse, is what I'm still cherishing here with. Can I share my personal note on this? My personal note, I want to share it. Am I audible?
Sir, you are audible, sir.
I have a small personal note on this. For this eclipse, let me tell you, most of the eclipses was helped by non-astronomical institutes. they were helped by, in this case, I was helped by my own vegetable vendor next door to me, who said, why don't you go for the eclipse? We are proud of you, or we are happy that you are going to go and see it. So they were giving us soft loans without interest to go and see the eclipse. Another event I want to share, in fact, it makes me emotionally a little sad that we had so many institutes. Still, the effort from that vegetable vendor, from that travel agent, and from so many people, the helping hands came up. In fact, to tell you a short tale, when I landed in La Paz, the flight reached at 2 o'clock in the morning. And normally the process in Mexico and US, they close down the airport after the last flight has come, which means you are not even allowed to stay inside the airport as you do it at T1, T2 and so on. What happened there? There was one, I was waiting and there was no rooms, no hotel available. There was one, for me, a lucky taxi driver who said, where do you want to go? I said, I want to go to La Paz. And I had landed in La Cabos, which was nearly 200 kilometers from La Paz. So he said, see, there are no buses operating at this hour. So why don't you come and stay in my shed for that night? And early morning, I will see that you are reaching the bus stand so you can go to La Paz. And mind you, I had to stay with him overnight at his shed. And why he gave me all this? Because it is the helping hand. And this helping hand helped me all the way to go up to the bus stand. And from the bus stand, he instructed, I could not speak Mexican. But this person knew broken English and he helped me. When I went to pay him, he said, no, sir, we are proud that we are having people like you coming all over from India to see the eclipse. And he did not take a single taxi fare from me. Except he said, whenever you go back to India, can you give us your film, your film magazines? You can send it to me. I'm a great fan of Indian films, that is all. But in La Paz also, I was dropped just outside the hotel in which I was supposed to stay. And again here, I want to share with you, a corona year doesn't mean a lockdown. You are actually traveling to so many places, seeing so many events, and this is what happens for any eclipse chaser. This is my experience I'm sharing with you. Can I have the next slide? Yeah, one more slide which I'm showing you. This was taken by 80mm Zeiss refractor, and you will see more details here. But one of the most interesting feature is here, you find a jet, which is called as a coronal jet. And here the reddish thing that you see are prominences, which means the gases from the sun are thrown out. And that's how we are able to see a prominence also during a solar eclipse. So can we move further? So this eclipse happened in India. Eclipse happened in India near Bharatpur. The place was called as Andhyari. And again here, we went as a group of Amateur Astronomers Association, and we were a team of nearly the same number, 80. But fortunately, we had better cameras and better setup by now. because we had gone through different phases, and interestingly, this eclipse was seen from Andhari, which is in Rajasthan. And again here, we again repeat, we were using only films. This is 95. There were many people who had gone to Taj Mahal, Fatehpur Sikri, all along the belt. We decided to remain because our totality time was only 50 seconds. So we had to do the best in 50 seconds. And there we were able to see these streamers also coming across the sky. And this was an early morning event. So we were able to see the outer corona, and then you can now go to the next exposure. Hello. Yeah. Now this was closer, what we call it as middle corona. In coronas also, your inner corona, middle corona, and the outer corona. Outer corona can extend up to 20 times the sun's time, sun's radius. And sometimes it can move beyond that. And when this happens, you have to be observing and careful. This is what we were able to do. And you will find exposures, how much time we had given, and how the images were scanned. All remember, we had scanners which were doing this job of digitizing the images. So please remember that all today, the whole solar eclipse is on your desktop or on your laptop. Can we move to the next?
Arre wa, whole solar eclipse.
Yeah.
Now,
now this eclipse is the same eclipse, but then by now we had learned a little more about how to find equal density points about the brightness of the corona. And this, we were able to plot it, and these are called as isolines or isoclines or isophotes. These are the words for determining the brightness of the corona. And again, here again, I would like to tell you, there's a yellow feature which tells you about the exact position of the photosphere edge, which means you can even now find the diameter of the sun as well as the moon and find the distance. It's that close. Can we have the next slide? Now, this is from Iran, 1999. Coming closer to 1999, I'm showing here only one image, and there are many more. We are doing that work also. So I am showing you one image of the inner corona. The objective here is to look for different coronas. Mind you, here also in Isfahan, Iran, the locals refuse to look at the eclipse. They put their heads down on the ground till the eclipse was over. Turkey also, people did see. There also we had our team members gone there. They have also recorded a similar event. So eclipses are now chased by a larger and larger community. Can we move to the next? Wow. This is Lusaka, which means Africa. Now in Africa, we were only two or three teams. I don't know about other teams, but I know PRL was there. This group over here, which is N.M. Ashok from Physical Research Laboratory and T. Chandrasekhar, had set up a Fabry-Perot instrument over there. And they were fairly far from us. And this is the eclipse that we saw there. And this eclipse was seen not by us, by one of our friends who had seen the eclipse in, because there are a lot of parks. Elephant Park is there, Giraffe Park is there. So people were also closer to these parks, they were able to see this. And again, here also you will see that the photographic trend had slowly changed by year time. Now it had come to a process where digital cameras were slowly stepping in. CCD cameras had come in. For this experiment which you are seeing here was done with a CCD camera. And while the objective was to look for flash spectrum and the spectra of this corona. And here you will see the Victoria Falls, which was another attraction. I think my talk is becoming more of travelogue and less of astronomy. So I don't want to do that. I will tell you that here also, the same films which we used to do with films, now here we were doing with DSLR cameras. And we were able to, I am going to show you more of this. Can I have the next? Yeah. Here also you will see the Bailey's beads and the prominences. And the sky was excellent in both the condition. Eclipse over here was 3 minutes and 31 seconds. And the best part over here, we were using larger cameras, which was, the plates were larger. Again, when you use photographic plates, they need to be digitized. Can we have the next slide? Now here you will see flare as well as the Bailey's beads. Now this is what we are able to collect from our eclipse coronal data. We are not looking at Bailey's beads alone. No, we are also looking at the corona. Can we go to the next slide? Here you see so many petals coming out of the sun. Have you seen so many coronal petals out of the sun? Please make an effort to see this. And definitely you will be charmed by that. It is such a fantastic event that you will never be able to forget it all your lifetimes. So here also we did some analysis of bright isolines, and this was mainly to make a fairly high resolution images for the corona. High resolution which I'm talking here is that, now later I will show you what we were able to see. Can we move to the next? Now this was an outer corona, but along with that we were using satellite data also. And with the satellite data, what all we were able to pick up to 30 solar radii, we were able to pick up a comet. And here is Jupiter. Okay. So, and then the stars. That was also visible. So you are not just looking at corona alone. You are looking at corona with planets, with stars, and it is a great sight to watch. So outer corona, the inner part of the Soho Lasco coronagraphic plates were taken, and from that we were able to get this long coronal streamers, which are about 30 times the sun's radius. Can we move to the next? Now this was a, I don't know how I would put it, but definitely I would like to show you. We had not planned to see the eclipse. One of our friends was near Kailash, and we were at Mansarovar during that period. For us, we were seeing the partial eclipse of the sun. But this was the first time in my lifetime I was looking at a crescent sun about Mount Kailash. Yes. I do not have the photograph of that, but yes, we have collected a photograph, but that was only of the sun, not the crescent sun with Mount Kailash. Yes, I have not done any photoshopping or anything on the image. So this is what I want to share with you. Can I have the next slide, please? What did we see in this eclipse? We saw a star cluster. We saw Mercury. We saw Moon. We saw a comet. And then we saw corona up to 20 times the sun's diameter. And how was that possible? Because the event was happening at an altitude of about 15,000 feet above the sea level. The sky was fabulous. The event was fabulous. Even when we were seeing the sun's crescent, the top of the Kailash was looking golden. This was my expression for this event. So I think I have two more slides to go. And this was the last eclipse, that last means total solar eclipse. We saw it from Carbondale and in US. Fortunately here also, helping hands were many. The university, Southern Illinois University, had made arrangements for us to go there and see the eclipse. And they had made all the arrangements. One thing that I realized, what it is to work with such professional amateur astronomers. They had made concrete pads for each observer. So I had to set up my telescope on that concrete height. The idea was that there should be no ground vibration going to the camera. And mind you, I will finally try to show you one more, which we did it from Nileshwar. I have my friend Rajiv around. He was a good meteo man for us to help us with the clouds and all that. And these were the pictures taken by our member at Nileshwara. And this was the annual solar eclipse 2019. And here I will like to thank all my teammates who made this happen. Nothing happens without your teammates. Nothing happens without helping hands. People who were there, they did help us even in an accommodation, keeping our all-sky camera live for the whole night and the following morning was only possible because of our Akash Ganga team members. So I think, is there a next slide, my dear? Now you see, this is an image which was taken and later processed. I will show you the processing part also. You will see a lot of helmets here. These are called as coronal helmets. There is a coronal upsurge, and in between that there is a plasma over here. And these are the nodes of that. So you can see plenty of coronal helmets seen during a solar corona. And this event, you can even measure whatever the streams which are coming out, the magnetic field lines, you can actually measure the length as well as the breadth of these coronal strains. And is there one more slide? Yes. This is my last slide, where I'm saying solar eclipses and the corona was not an eclipse of time, hardship or misery. Only now we face the coronal lockdown. Thank you very much. And maybe I may be able to answer a few questions.
And thanks a lot, sir, for the fantastic talk, because it was a trip down the memory lane from 1980 to 2020. And I suppose that majority of the members were not even born, the participants of this webinar, of the times you are talking about. So if you give us a due permission, we have received a few questions on both the platforms, on social media, as well as on my personal WhatsApp, because there were a lot of people who have pinged me upon my personal number. They were fearing that their question may be lost in the talk that was going on. And also there are a few questions in the chat box as well. So if you kindly permit, then I would request my co-host Swapnil Rastogi ji also to come into the play. And you kindly, Swapnil ji, you kindly search for the questions in the chat box. And in the meantime, Bharat sir, with your due permission, can I ask a few questions which I have received over the social media platform?
Yes,
absolutely, sir. I am also looking some question on the chat box. Thank you.
Sure. So, sir, beginning with, I would just not name the people, that is the people who are asking and all. So, the first question is from Mr. Rajiv. That is, how do you get to know the weather patterns before the eclipse and how to plan for the exposures about the eclipse? Over to you, sir.
Yeah. Now, the weather patterns, what we normally tend to look at is the 50-year-old data. Now that data in the current times needs to be revised, because we have to know the local status. And one more thing, going to an eclipse doesn't mean only going to a site and setting up your equipment. You got to know which site is going to be ideal for the photometry, for the spectroscopy, for polarimetry, or for shear photography. You got to know the site. And the pattern which was conveyed during the December eclipse was people were crowding in spite of the fact that those places were actually made aware that there will be heavy rains. And people did flock there, and they had bad misery, and they had to move from there to better sites. I know my friends had difficulty from Coimbatore to go to other parts of Tamil Nadu, or they even had to go down to Ooty. So I'm completely aware of that situation. Hence, we take a lot of precaution to determine the weather pattern in this area where the central line is passing. Please remember this. We are following the central line of the totality. So whenever we are looking for the weather, we are looking for the central line weather pattern. Have I answered your question, Rajiv ji?
Thank you, sir. Thanks. Rajiv ji is pinging me. Thanks a lot. So the next question is from Mr. Varun. He is telling me, sir, he is a plus two student, and you had talked about the interferometry in one of your photographs in Africa eclipses. So he just wants to know about two things. Number one, sir, what is the interferometry application in eclipses? And second one, is there any formula for eclipses to repeat at the same place?
For equations or mathematical. Hello.
Yes, sir. You are audible, sir. Kindly continue, sir.
There are two parts to this. Why interferometry is the first question. Now you will be seeing in this picture so many magnetic field lines are coming out. Okay. Now they have to be resolved. That means the closer lines, how close are they? And that one can resolve by using an interferometer. Interferometer is not very difficult. One can make it right inside now in lockdown condition also. All you need is a pinhole, one pinhole, then you have two pinholes and you see when the light goes through first pinhole and then the same light goes through the two pinholes, it forms a pattern. Now this can be done inside the house. I have done it in my house and I will ask the young friends, you should do experiments not only in schools and college labs. You should try to do it within your house also. Yeah, you may get some scolding from your parents. That is besides the point. But you will learn something new for yourself. You will enjoy it. That yes, I was able to understand interferometer by only using three pinholes. How many? Three pinholes. The first pinhole we will call it as primary and the secondary will have two pinholes. And then those two pinholes will be not very far from each other. They will be only 1 inch apart, 2 inches apart, 3 inches apart. You can try and see the patterns, which will tell you that the same pinhole is now showing you a whole pattern. So these are simple things. One can do it in the eclipses. And this is how people are doing it for Febri Perro, which we saw in the African eclipse. And the next question, you can get now equations of the whole solar eclipse, whether it is Saros cycle, all that is today available on your computers. All that you have to do is go to the computer, give in your latitude and longitude. It will tell you how big eclipse you are going to see. How, whether it is a partial, whether it is a total, all that today you get it on your laptop or your computers. I hope I have answered those two questions.
So thanks Bharat sir, and now over to Swapnil because we are finding a bunch of questions over the chat box. So respecting the people who are posting over the chat box, over to you before I find other questions in my WhatsApp.
Okay sir, yeah. So first of all sir, this is Swapnil Rastogi, and as you can see I have some questions over the chat box. And if also pardon me if any question I misses it, so please put it again on the chat box. So first question, as I can see over the chat box by Mr. Shitish Srivastav, so he is asking why core of sun rotates faster than its surface.
Yes, it does. It does at the equatorial regions. It is 25 days, but that is the solar rotation. The sun rotates on its axis, and when it is rotating, it is also doing its precession cycles. So whenever we are observing any eclipses, we do need two components of the sun. One is the B component and one is the L component. Both these eclipses, these coordinates, help us into telling how the sun is oscillating on its own axis. Okay, coming to the second part of your question, then the question arises, does the corona also rotate? It's an open question. Probably that may provoke you to see more eclipses. Does the corona rotate? And if it rotates, what is the rotational velocity? And as it is rotating, what is happening to the coronal streamers? Obviously, towards the magnetic poles of the sun, you may not find much. But towards the equatorial region, what is the speed of the coronal corona itself? I'm not talking about coronal streamers alone. I'm talking of corona itself. Does it rotate on its axis, on the sun's axis? And the answer should be yes. I am not measured it. We intend to measure it. But yes, we need more and more inquisitive minds or ignited minds to come and tell us how to do it, where to do it, and most important, that we should not just depend on this institute, that institute. We should start thinking afresh. One thing good about the present lockdown is, I'm very happy, is we are made to think about the subjects on which we thought we can only give a lecture in colleges, we can only give lectures in schools. But now I'm very happy, thanks to Amritanshu for pulling me into this. Now I'm feeling confident that we should be able to do more of these citizen scientist program. And let me tell you why we are doing citizen scientist. India had only one Nobel Prize in physics, and that is C.V. Raman. And from that time till date, there are no Nobel laureates within the country. So our hope is to bring our citizen scientists to do greater scientist missions like these and find what they can do. And I am sure you will be able to like it. And any more questions, sir?
Yes, sir. Sir, thanks a lot for your holistic vision. And there is another question by Shitesh Srivastav. Why gravity needs to be quantized?
Well, here I'm not going to answer this, because I'm also trying to study that. And for me, it's a big question. And I'm also trying to understand that. Until I understand, I don't make an effort to answer that.
Okay, sir. I hope like our Shitesh Srivastav can understand this. So there's another question by Rajiv. Sir, is there any difference between eclipses occurring during different stages of sunspot cycle?
Yes, there are. The corona totally depends on the number of sunspots and the shape of the corona. They are all depending on the sun's surface. So this is the straight answer for the corona. The shapes of the corona will definitely change. If it is a minima, a solar minima, solar maxima, you do tend to see these kind of features.
Okay, sir. Sir, I have one another question. Sir, could you please tell us something about NASA's Parker Solar Probe? What is its mission objective and how it will help us in understanding heliophysics?
See, there are many experiments mounted on that that satellite, right from looking at iron lines, then nickel lines, chromium lines, not sorry, chromium, krypton lines, and beyond that, it also has a coronagraphic camera which is going to take the pictures of the sun even when there is no eclipses, which means they are doing artificial corona. And for your information, India is likely to send its satellite either by next year or by early 2002. It is known as Aditya, and there is a coronagraphic camera also on that satellite, and that satellite Aditya will be placed at a Laplacian point to look at the sun continuously.
So thanks.
Wow, sir, I saw straight interrupt to you, sir.
Pardon? Swapnil, just kindly wait so that I can ask a couple of questions, and you can find out the most relevant questions related to the talk before we wind up the talk. So, sir, on behalf of Mr. Arun, I am asking a couple of questions. The first question that he has posed is, that is, which file format do you prescribe for taking the photograph of the eclipse, which gives us the most detailing according to your experiences? And what is the meaning of lunar limb correction?
One important thing that I have to mention we do have to take in consideration of lunar liberation. This is important because the moon which is there, it has hills and valleys. Now when it covers to some part of it, we have to do the and the moon is also moving. Please remember this. Even in Nileshwar, we did have these problems. And the moon is coming from one end and making an elliptical motion and moving out. So during an eclipse, moon plays a very major role. And it is essential to know that lunar limb profile has to be understood very well. And there are only at present, Chandrayaan is one satellite which gives you good images. Then there is a Japanese satellite called as Kagayu. And then there is one more, which is a lunar satellite, which is going around the moon. That also is giving. So using all that, we have to create a proper lunar limb profile to see what is not going to be obstructed by the moon and what is going to be obstructed by the what is not going to be obstructed by the moon. So those regions will slowly emerge out. I hope I have answered your question.
Sure, sir. Thank you. And with due respect to all the people who have sent me questions over the WhatsApp and other social media,
Can I make a small comment here?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You are welcome to write to akashgangaobservatory@gmail.com with any of your queries, and we will definitely try to answer that.
Sure, sir. We shall be sharing the due contact of yours in the course of time. That can be helpful for the audience also. So with due respect to all the people who are sending their questions over the social media, this is the last question that I am taking on your behalf. We are not skipping any questions, but at the same time, they will be mailed to our expert, Dr. Bharat Adur, by admin@skyfoundation.org. And Swapnil, I would also request you to kindly browse for the most relevant and the best of the couple of questions from your bag. Before we proceed for the final closure of the session. So the question that comes is, sir, what is your advice for the 2020 event by Mr. Narayan Singh, and what do you mean by Saros cycle?
Yeah, now Saros cycle is the event which are going to happen after 18 and a half months are called as Saros cycle, but these are there for each eclipse. Each eclipse doesn't have the same kind of Saros cycle. It is different. So you can actually find out which Saros cycle this eclipse belongs. Okay. And these cycles are normally 18 and a half months. So you can even see which all eclipses are in Saros cycle 130, 140, like that. So this is how Saros cycle is going to. And for a detailed answer, you please send me your email. I will give you, including the reference, how to calculate a Saros cycle depending on particular eclipse. And another thing that I want to tell you, now the Saros cycle has been even cataloged by Fred Espanac in his catalog of eclipses. And there again, you will see for different cycles, he has made a table. So how that 18 months comes in and goes out, you can see. Have I answered your query?
Sure, sir. Actually, sir, you have answered the half part. The first half was, what is your advice for 2020 event, upcoming 2020 event?
Yeah, I purposely stopped on that, but I have firstly answered your Saros. Now on 2020, now the eclipse is not going to be very long, if you all recall, it's going to be a very short event. And the event has to be observed from the time, as you know, there are C1, C2, C3 and C4. All these four contact points have to be known. And this is important for you to find the path of the, in Nileshwar, we were able to get the contact point times also and the totality. Here you don't get totality, you get ring of fire. So ring of fire is what we are looking at. And since you are also going to see the rim of the sun, you should make an effort to analyze that. In fact, I am told some young friends have been able to mobilize. This is my suggestion to all the observers who are planning to look for the eclipse, but it is a teamwork. Don't think that, okay, I have a camera and I own the camera and it is my proprietary right. No. The ring of fire is the proprietary right of every one of us. So don't stop anyone. And if possible, if you have a camera and you are not going to use it, pass it to people who are going to observe it. Let us not have this dog in the manger attitude for any of the eclipses or any of the celestial events. And now we have quite a number of events that we are there. You should be able to find it.
Sure, sir. Thank you, sir. And so actually, sir, out of curiosity, can I have the pleasure of asking you a thing, sir? Can we kindly think of removing the filter at the time of annularity? Because I suppose this is going to be a very deep event with 99% of the sun covered.
Yeah, you have to remove the filter. Still, you have 1% of the light. But let me tell you, you have to take sufficient care for your eyes. Can you ensure that?
Sure. So now over to Swapnil. You kindly proceed for asking the final two questions before we head for the closure.
Okay, sir. So there is like another question from Avnish Bajpai in the chat box, and he's asking, is there any change you observed in gravitational field between Moon, Earth and Sun during the eclipses?
Well, I have not studied gravitational part of it, because for that there are now a lot of LIGO equipments available, if I'm not mistaken, or they are in the making. They should be able to give us more highlight on LIGO experiments, because they are looking for gravitational fields and so on. So I think I do not come into that realm yet, but yes, I am also interested in looking at such gravitational fields.
And sir, there is a last question in the chat box, as I can see, by Saksham. He's asking, what is the instrument used to measure the power and the temperature of sun's corona?
Okay. Now, for that, here you have to use a different kind. Here, you know what we, as we do for any astronomy, we here look for the spectral lines and look for the ionization lines, and thereby we are able to say whether the temperatures are in Kelvin, that is 6000 degrees, or whether it is in million degrees. Because these streamers have very high temperatures, and using thermometers for that will not help. You need newer methods, newer techniques. Your spectroscopy is one of them. And I would strongly suggest, try to use some spectroscopic observations. You can find the temperatures also. Is that okay?
Yeah, sir, I guess. Okay, sir. So, thank you, sir, for giving the answer so generously. What our participants ask the questions in the chat box, whether in the mailbox or everywhere. So that's all from my end. I am just overing to Amritanshu Bajpai. Over to you from my end. Thank you, sir.
Thanks a lot, Swapnil, for helping me out in this tedious task of asking the questions, because what to choose and what not to is, you can say, one of the most of the tedious tasks in a program. And sir, before I proceed for the formal closure of this talk, sir, actually, I, with due respect, I have been you can say forced by many participants to ask this question because they have been continuously seeing your photographs, processed photographs and all. Sir, can you kindly guide us for the post image processing of the solar eclipse? And this, I assure you, will be the final question from our part.
Well, people are used to Photoshops. I would strongly suggest you can use Photoshops, but along with that, you may need many more softwares for correction, the imaging and all that. But if you are using DSLR cameras, please try to take your images in the raw format. I hope I'm making myself fairly clear, but also take other features like bias, dark frame, then also flats. Because if you are taking images in three color or maybe in LRGB, you may have to have so many flats. So convert your raw films into calibrated images and then use it for calibration or for your reduction. And softwares, yes, I have told you about Photoshop. You can try some more also that are available. And you will definitely find new venues to look at. And I wish you all the very best to see the solar eclipse, which is happening on June 20th.
Thanks a lot, sir. I would extend a sincere thanks on behalf of all the coordinating institutes and all the coordinating bodies which have organized the talk for the day and have given me the opportunity to host as well. And so actually this was a trip down the memory lane, as I have already mentioned, and out of one of the few rare celestial events that we are to witness. And as an Indian, I would make a sincere, humble request to all the people to kindly join in this pursuit for watching the solar eclipse. It is because the next annularity that you are going to see will be on 21st of May 2031. So there are 11 years and next totality will be in India in 2034. So this is one of the rare events. It could be a lifetime event for a person. So do not try to miss this spectacle that is approaching us within a span of say about 12 to 13 days. All the very best. So with these words, I would just present a very warm word of thanks to all the organizers, and especially not to forget the Skype Scientific Knowledge for Youth Foundation, which has provided us the platform for presenting this Astronomy Delights series, and also the three coordinating VIPnet clubs, United Minds VIPnet Club, Sky Amateur Astronomers Club, and Women-Led Science Club, and EduSTEM Initiative Global. And a sincere thanks from the core, deepest core of my heart to the guest of honor, Dr. Bharat Adur, who has addressed and who has taken the adventurous ride of watching a solar eclipse to a seventh heaven. I really say from the deepest core of my heart. And also special thanks to all the audience who had joined us in huge number and had shown the patience of hearing this talk from the beginning till the end, and the wonderful plethora of queries that you have posted us. Special thanks to the TMW group who has been present intact since the beginning, and also special thanks to the director Jawaharlal Nehru Planetarium, Prayagraj, erstwhile Allahabad, Dr. Y. Ravikiran for gracing the occasion, and the different dignitaries, Dr. Krishnanand Sinha and all who had been present over the course of this entire talk. So with these words, I wish all the audience a very happy sky observation, a very happy night sky observation, and a very, very happy annular solar eclipse observation as well. Wishing you all luck, success for this watching of the upcoming event over which Dr. Bharat sir has given an insight upon. With these words, I take leave on behalf of the Sky Foundation, thanking you all for joining me. And the recording of this talk will be uploaded over the YouTube channel of the Sky Foundation. Kindly stay tuned with us over the different social media platforms. It will also be uploaded over the channel of Akash Ganga Center for Astronomy in coordination with Sky. And so over the screen, you can see the details of the speaker of the day, and you can take a screenshot of it. And if you send the queries, those queries will be sent to the speaker and they will be duly answered. So with these words, I take a leave with the sole message. Happy sky observation session in the age of corona pandemic. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay home. And yes, do venture out to watch the annular solar eclipse. Good night and have a nice time ahead.